want to share with you is, and students, this is important that you have a conversation about it with your teachers and your parents as well. Take risks. Whether you are young or old, take risks. You are today entering your youth, right? We are past it. But let me tell you one thing. There is nothing that gives me a greater blood rush, a greater sense of excitement than taking a risk. Take risks. Take big risks in life. The more risks you take, the more fruitful your life will be. Of course, calculated risks. But think about it. Don't let fear ever overcome you. And now let me share the one risk which I took, which was useful for me in the long run. But when I took it, everybody said that, I'm making the biggest mistake of my life. In 2004, I quit NDTV. I quit NDTV in 2004. And believe me, everyone wrote me off. Everyone. When you take risks, you will be written off. And especially if you're young and you take risks, many people will write you off. And everybody will tell you to tread the beaten path, everything. Let me tell you about my risk and what it taught me. I left NDTV in 2004. At a very young age, I was a senior editor. I had a good salary. I had bought a house. I had a small child. I was, as they say, in the ultimate Indian lingo, I was settled. You know what I mean? Have you been told to be settled or not? How many of you raise your hands? How many students have been told to get settled quickly? All right. Yeah. Okay, good. I can see quite a few of you raise your hands. So that's good. I was settled. It was ridiculous to leave NDTV at that time. Ridiculous. I remember when I was leaving, I think Pranoy Roy was surprised. And he asked me, he said, why do you want to leave NDTV? I gave him a really honest reply. I said, Pranoy, I want to create a second source of employment for English language journalists who are doing television in India. Because at that time, there was only NDTV. Now imagine one individual leaves a mothership. The mothership is 100 times the Titanic. You have no idea how dominant NDTV was in 2004. There was only NDTV. There was Doordarshan and NDTV. And for somebody who has broken through the ranks, worked hard, become a senior editor in NDTV, to leave it all and leave the city and leave Delhi, which is the Mecca of journalism, as they say. It certainly is not. And then go to Mumbai and think of starting a channel was unbelievably ridiculous. And to make your family move and everyone move to leave your house, it was just, I was the laughing stock for the longest time. And I'll tell you one story. I used to love seeing movies in PVR at that time. It was not called PVR, but there was a movie. There was the only swanky movie hall in Delhi at that point of time was Priya Cinema. I'm sure it exists. It's Vasant Kunj area near JNU. And I would love going there. So after leaving NDTV, I was asked when I was being interviewed by the Times of India, you know everything about launching a channel. I said, yes, absolutely. They said, everything. I said, Abhi, am I audible to you? Rajita, you can hear me, right? Just raise your hand if you can.
It's fluctuating a little bit, but you're audible, yeah.
I remember that I was asked, do you know everything about launching a channel? I said, yes. Believe me, I had no idea. But I've never been shy of accepting challenges or making a claim. So I said, yes, of course I know. After getting the job, which was to launch a TV channel for India's biggest media group, I was in a fix. I remember calling some of my best friends down to a coffee shop near Priya Cinema. And I remember sitting down with a paper And there were four or five sitting there. One person is from production, one is from a camera department, one is an editor, one is a reporter. I said, guys, I want to ask you something. They said, what? I said, how do we start a TV channel? They said, why are you asking us? I said, because I'm going to launch a TV channel. And believe me, everyone spilled their coffee and they had a good laugh. And we all laughed for the longest time. They thought it was a con job. The reason I'm telling you this is because life is the biggest education you will get later. Learning a TV channel, launching a TV channel is not written in any book. And if I had not said yes to the challenge, I would not have taken the risk. So I go back to the point, students, take risks because life will teach you the way. If your purpose is clear and your heart is clean, and if your effort is straight, your integrity is with you, don't imagine that there is any perfect way. I'll talk about it later. Sometimes in life, students, we don't take a challenge because we believe that we don't know something and someone else knows the way. There is no perfect way. Don't avoid taking the risk because you think that you need to take the risk after having made the complete plan. There is no complete plan. There is no, for me, there was no prototype of launching a TV channel. You know, if I had gone around looking for a book that taught me, I would have not found the book. If I had gone around looking for a teacher who would have taught me, I would have not found the teacher. The book is within you. The teacher is within you. The problem is, we don't look for our teacher within. We don't look for the book within. We want someone else to do it for us. So students, take risks, have faith in yourself, keep your family together, but have the courage to take the risk.